This video is for education and entertainment. This is not financial advice. All technical analysis in this video were made for pure speculation and opinion. Do not try any of these strategies for yourself. You are responsible for your own money. Do your own research. What's crackalackin', everyone? MG here, and I'm back with another cryptocurrency video. So let's get into it. Market cap 1.8 trillion, probably 1.9 trillion coming up here at the end of the day. We are fucking up 14.7%, boys. Ladies and germs, 24-hour volume is $440 billion. BTC dominance has climbed by almost 2%. ETH dominance has dumped. And the gas fees are now back to 124 Gwei, which is hilarious. So if you caught my video yesterday, you know what I'm saying? The message still holds true. You know what I'm saying? Do not panic. This is normal. This is expected behavior in our market. And if you are new, congratulations. You have just survived the most intense BTC dump in history. Excuse me. So, congratulations. Pat yourself on the back. You know what I'm saying? Crypto time dilation is 1 day in crypto is like 2 weeks in the real world. So here we go. BTC sitting at $41,629. It's down 0.7% on the hourly, up 4.6% from yesterday. Ethereum chilling at 2900. It's probably gonna hit 3k today. Binance coin is above $400. Cardano ripped the fuck up. We can see here all of these greens, okay, on the 24-hour board. XRP really took it hard. Looks like it's still dumping, but it's okay. Doge is back up 2.6%. Polkadot up 1.7%. Bitcoin Cash still dumping. It's back to three figures, probably going to shoot up to four figures once we start pumping again. Litecoin 216, Uniswap down to February prices for sure. That's a steal right there. Chainlink $31, another steal. Polygon, Matic finally cooled the fuck off, sub $2. Solana cooled off as well. Stellar, ETH Classic 170, 174, and Theta is still below $8, so, you know. Overall, looking pretty good. You know, we're not out of the woods yet. I want to see us close the weekly green, and then I'll start to feel pretty good. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. So, in today's video, we will be covering TA for two coins. One will be for VeChain, okay? Excuse me, in fact, let me actually take a sip of my drink here. Today's beverage of choice is black coffee, straight. No cream, no sugar. You know, no cream, no sugar until we're back up. Because, you know, your boy, up only. So this is VeChain. It is a older project, okay, very established. And the second one will be PancakeSwap. And, you know, your boy has been fucking around with BNC dumpster juice coins, okay? BNC dumpster juice coins, and I'm making some weird money, guys. So those are the two coins that we're going to be covering. But before we do that, let's actually start with some BTC. See what's going on here real quick, you know. So let's take a look at the 1 day, okay? So again, all EMA ribbons have gone bearish. The money flow index is looking bloody. It's starting to create some blood here. Okay, we can see that there. VWAP is acting as resistance. And we can see that this anchor wave here is forming to the downside. It has not confirmed a bottom yet. That's what I'm looking for. And right now, we not only did we clean break the 200-day moving average, we're still below it. So, not quite out of the woods just yet, boys. But you know, I'm still optimistic. I'm still positive. I'm still bullish on this. So that's definitely one thing that we gotta keep an eye out for. And same with the weekly as well. It's looking like we almost wicked down and touched the 50-day. We were well above the 200-day moving average. The weekly, this weekly candle, the bloodiest one that we've had in weeks, is confirming a bearish confirmation. EMA ribbons are bullish. We are still above the 50 and 200-day moving average. VWAP is acting as support, and money flow is looking very, very good. Peaks, tops confirmed, and it's looking like it wants to go to the downside. I'm hoping that BTC will do one of these. Confirm bottom and just keep going. You know, just maintaining that upward trend, because again, guys, fundamentally nothing has changed with BTC, so what the fuck is it thumping? Okay? So I want this to close green, and I'll feel really, really good. We got 3 days left, so as far as I'm concerned, BTC, the bulls are still holding it down. I'm so glad that Asia fucking bought the dip, you know what I'm saying? They saved our bacon. So that's BTC. Let's take a look at Ethereum real quick. Where is Ethereum USD pair? So it's looking like I got some fibs here. I think that was from yesterday. So we'll look at the 1 day. Let me actually just remove all that trash. Let's get it clean here. So it's looking like we broke clean through the 50-day and we almost touched the 200-day moving average. It's looking like Ether wants to continue to the downside. A bottom has not been confirmed yet, and it's fucking whopping 8 hours until the next candle will print. So what I'm hoping is that it will at least confirm a bottom or get into that shape, so we can then see where the local bottom is, so we can then plan accordingly. Like, I would probably fucking long that dip, but you know, we're not out of the woods just yet. That's just what I'm thinking right now. I'm just thinking out loud. So we'll go to the 4 hour. Multiple bottoms confirmed. This bottom was confirmed at 1 p.m. What's today's date? Yesterday. Okay. And another one confirmed at 9 a.m. So that's good. If you caught this bottom and you longed it, you're looking pretty good. You still got about 5 minutes left till that next 4 hour candle prints. EMA ribbons have gone bearish. One bearish confirmation there. This might be an infusion pump, but it's looking like this anchor wave wants to print to the upside. Money flow is starting to get bloody. VWAP is acting as resistance. Okay, we are below the 250-day moving average, so we'll see what the bulls want to do. Let's just flip up to the 1 hour. 1 hour is looking quite nice. The money flow index is still bloody. EMA ribbons have gone bearish still. We are breaking past the 50-day. We need to break past the 200-day as well. Trend reversal confirmed, followed by three bullish confirmations as well. But this is looking like it's a top is going to be confirmed pretty soon. And what I'm hoping is that when the top is confirmed, it will just do a pattern like this. No bullshit to the downside. We don't want that. Not today. Okay, not this week. Okay, let's just recover. Let's move on. Because, you know, BTC Miami's coming in a couple, I think 2 to 3 weeks. You know, let's be at 70,000 to 80,000 plus for BTC for that event, because it's gonna be fucking awkward as fuck if not. So here we go. Let's do VeChain. If you guys don't know what VeChain is it's a very old project. Full disclaimer: I am not invested in VeChain. I have a lot of homies who are. You know, shout out to you guys. I almost considered aping it into this coin because it was looking really juicy with that dump, but now it's getting expensive again. So from what I understand, it VeChain is a smart contract play. Their main value prop back in the days when it was shilled to me in 17 was they're going to fight the war on counterfeiting. Okay, so proof of authority, I think that's what it is. So, you know, just to prevent counterfeiting, that type of shit. And they have a long laundry list of clients up into including Walmart, which is huge. Wally World, especially if you live in the States. That's a big chain company that that we just shop at. You know, I pick up fucking cheap games there, guys. Like new Nintendo Switch games and PS4 games that are typically retail for about 60 USD. They're like $49.99 at Walmart. So, you know. So let's get after it. Let's do the 1 month here for VeChain. Okay. And let me tell you guys something, like this coin just never moves. Like I have friends who've been holding this coin for years and the fucker just never moves, and finally it starts moving, you know. So it's looking like VeChain is posting good monthlies here. We got these strong candles up here, and it's looking like a top has yet to be confirmed in the monthly, so that's looking very good as well. So when we look at the weekly, good money flow. We got good peaks here. This bottom was confirmed on the 16th of November. If you aped in on the 16th of November, congratulations. You're in a very good place, even though we took a shit the past few days, because we can see that the huge run-up just happened with VeChain. So if you scooped up here at 1 cent and you rode it all the way up to a quarter, that's definitely a nice trade. But you know people who are into this coin are in it for the long term, and that's the kind of mindset that you want for these type of projects. So when we go to the 1 day, we can see that the dump has definitely affected it. It has collapsed below the 50 and the 200 day moving average. Well, it wicked down, but it's back up. It is under the 50 day, but it's well above the 200 day, which is very good. The EMA ribbons are starting to converge, which tend to be bearish. Money flow is looking like it's starting to peter off here, okay? And it's looking like a bottom has yet to be confirmed. So there's still time here. If you are trying to catch this pump, you could wait 8 hours and see if that bottom will confirm. Personally, I prefer to wait for the 4 hour confirmations. So the bottom for VeChain was confirmed yesterday at 1 p.m. So if you caught that, you're in a good place. You know, I was thinking about aping into this coin, but I did not. So, you know, that's where the research comes in. I know that this is a serious player. This is a serious coin. It is top 10, top 20 material. But, you know, for those types of investments, you need to have the full-scale research. This isn't like a coin that you fucking ape in and, you know, you trade it. This is one of them long, slow movers, kind of similar to like Cardano, you know, so that's my opinion on that. So as far as I'm concerned, it's looking like VeChain is recovering quite nicely. So we'll go down to the 1 hour. It's looking like a top was confirmed for the 1 hour. So depending on what your view is on this coin, this is definitely a dollar cost average strat. So I would probably set a support line there at 8 cents, and I would probably set resistance on this line here when the trend reversal was confirmed, trend reversal to the downside. But you know, I tend to like to use trend reversal signals as a resistance. So this would be your accumulation range here. So you're looking at a spread of about 110% up or down. So, you know, that's the range that you're going to be playing with. You know, again, if you believe in this project and you're in it for the long haul, this is just a great opportunity for you. You know what I'm saying? Just like yesterday, you know, I loaded up on more BPro, loaded up on more Wax, loaded up on more Luxo, you know, Cardano. Of course, I bought the Bitcoin dip and the Ether, but you know, I'm just talking about alts. Like, I was just scooping fucking coins out of my couch to buy this fucking dip, guys. Because, you know, I don't just be talking shit like, oh, buy the motherfucking dips. Like, no, I'm buying the shit, okay? I'm scrounging change in my couch. You know what I'm saying? So that's VeChain. VeChain is looking quite good to me. You know what I'm saying? And I know the fundamentals are good because I have friends who are shilling the fuck out of this coin since day one. You know, I probably should have gotten into it earlier too, but you know, I had my focus on other things. So yeah, VeChain looking good. Accumulation range, put in your stink bids here on the 9 cent or whatever, just between the range of 8 cent to 18 cents. That's that would be my play for VeChain. So now let's go to PancakeSwap. Okay, let's be real here. You know, I prefer Ethereum. I prefer Uniswap. You know, now especially Sushi, since it has the Matic Layer 2 live. However, I have been enjoying my time in PancakeSwap, fucking around with the BNC dumpster juice, fucking shit coins. Again, if you're in my Discord, I post what coins I'm buying there. You know, it's very degenerate. You know, aping at your own risk. I'm primarily fucking with PancakeSwap because of the speed and the reduced fees. Like, aping into coins in PancakeSwap is a fucking dream, because you can dump 10, 20 bucks if you want and pay only a dollar or sometimes less in fees versus Uniswap, where you want to, where minimum apish behavior starts at $500, because the higher the trade, the lower the fee in Uniswap. And you know, I'm not trying to flex, like I can ape into coins on Uniswap, but I'm also thinking about people who are playing with smaller margins, you know? Like, it's bullshit. Like, what if you just want to ape in 50 bucks? You know, oh, you're going to pay $300 in fees? Fuck that. So, you know, this is why I've been fucking around with PancakeSwap. It is a little, in terms of the UX, it's not as smooth as Uniswap, where Uniswap was literally just, it just works, and it was super easy to pick up and understand. With PancakeSwap, you know, you need a couple years of IT experience to set up the configuration for this, but once it's set up, it's fine. And again, full disclosure, I am not invested in PancakeSwap. I use it, but with Layer 2 coming soon for Uni, and, you know, I prefer Cardano and Ethereum. You know, I'm probably not going to be using this, like, as my main AMM, but, you know, a man's view can change, right? So, what the fuck is the marker? Is it called Cake? Okay, it's Cake. Okay, so we'll do Cake Tether. So let's take a look at the monthly. Not much data. I know it's a very new. It's very new. So 1, 2, 3, 4 posting 4 green months. Let's check out the weekly. Not much data here as well. We all know that everyone took a dump. It's looking like Pancake wicked down to $13. If you caught that dip yesterday, woo, you're up tremendously. So we'll look at the one day. So it's looking like EMA ribbons are starting to converge, and that generally is bearish. So we'll just draw some happy little trend lines there. Maybe we can do a support line here at this bottom wick here at 1360. Money flow, I can't really tell, but it's looking like it's starting to peter off, and we're probably going to see a confirmation here in the next 7 or close to 8 hours. Bottom confirmation, that's what we want. And it's looking like the bottom confirmed already on the 4 hour, which again is my preferred time frame when I long dips. So I would have probably longed here, and if I did, I'd be up quite a bit. So as far as the 4 hour is concerned, money flow not looking too good. Let me actually see, am I gonna get a fair price here? Yeah, so it's looking like if you wanted to get in to, oops, if you wanted to get into PancakeSwap as far as leverage trading, you would actually be getting a good price if you're gonna short. So that's always good to know. So you would be getting a good price if you're willing to short. Excuse me. So let's flip over to the 1 hour. Looking like a top was confirmed. Excuse me, fuck. And it's looking like this divergence happened, thus bringing it up to the upside there. Typically, when I see these two, when I see divergences like this, I typically long. I still think we're in a bear market, guys. And, you know, I know that this is the sea of red, but I'm the only reason why I would ever long a divergence like this, even though the money flow is bloody, is because we're all recovering from a huge hit that happened to all of our net worth, you know, for the past 3 days. So that's kind of like, I guess you could say, air quotes, a calculated risk there. But, you know, it all depends. Like me, my risk tolerance is very, very high. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, I kind of turn on the sociopath mode in my brain when it comes to this kind of trading shit. I do not get sweaty, I do not get emotional when it comes to this kind of stuff. It's like, you just gotta turn on that serial killer mode. So I fucking long that kind of shit when we're in these type of situations. It might bite me in the ass later when we were really entering bear county, but you know, right now I still think we're in the bull market, so that's what I would have done there. So as far as I'm concerned, if I were to make plays into pancake swap, I'd probably be eating on, god damn it, I'll probably be eating on the 5 minute and the 30, okay, and I'd be following the money flow. Right now money flow is looking good. Bottom is going to be confirmed there, so probably what I would do is I would just, for pancake swap, is I would just scalp the motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I'll wait for this bottom to confirm there, buy that bottom, ride it up. Once a top has been confirmed, and depending on the shapes of these divergences, if they go up or down, I'm just gonna go long or I'm gonna go short. That's pretty much what I do. Like, for some reason, these AMM plays work really well with scalping. I'm not sure, maybe I'm just lucky, who knows. I think I've told you guys before in previous videos that in February I scalped the fuck out of uni. Like, I just stayed in a trade for almost 8 hours, just trading it, scalping it, and I made some good money that day. So I don't know, I think it's because of the huge volume and the usage for these AMMs. It's just really good. So yeah, that's probably what I would do, you know, not financial advice. But yeah, so that is my TA for Pancake Swap and VeChain. You know what I'm saying? Again, let's refresh this. You know, keep your head up. Do not let these dips, you know, take over your life. I mean, we're going down again, which is okay, fine, whatever. But this is expected. 40,000 is the new resistance here. The new big even. And we just need to break out of the 200-day moving average, and we need to close this week green, and I'll be feeling good. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, stay safe out there, don't trip. You know, next week when we're fucking pumping back to the moon, this will just be a distant memory. So thanks again for your time, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.